Hello guys, this is Ryo69501 and welcome to my channel. Well, on this video I'm gonna give you my thought for this story arc. Actually it's from Batman book. It's called I Am Suicide. So it's a five part comic book, story arc, which start from Batman issue number 9. Check that out. Number 10, which is pretty cool color. Number 11, nice color. Number 12, and the last one, which is 13. Look at the eyes of Bane. Look at that. Awesome color. Okay, let's get to the story. The story is really simple. It's a continuation from the first story arc of Batman Rebirth. Remember, the first story arc is called I Am Gotham. Remember, where we see the Gotham boy and Gotham girl, Gotham and Gotham girl. Well, basically, this is a continuation about this story. Okay, after this story finished, we know that Gotham girl was rescued by Bruce Wayne and he took her to his mansion. And she's dying. She's dying, she's hallucinating, all kinds of stuff. The only person that who can save her is a person that actually make her sick, which is Psycho Pirate, female. So on this story arc, I Am Suicide, Batman is after Psycho Pirate. The thing is about Psycho Pirate is that, well, he's in Santa Prisca, where Bane is. So the thing is that, well, for having to go there. Well, he has kind of like, he has to make his own team to go there, because he's gonna go there by himself. I mean, he would not be able to do it by himself. So he decides to create a team. So he goes to Arkham Asylum. But before that, here he tells you a backstory of Bane when he was a kid. Not the same backstory as Vengeance of Bane from the 90s. This is more like when he was a kid and he was thrown into kind of like a dungeon. So every night or every other night that it rains, so his cell will fill up of water every night. So he has to survive that every single night for I don't know how many years. For a lot of years. And we see here Bane talking with Psycho Pirate. Okay. So Batman goes to Arkham Asylum. As we can see here. Awesome page. Look at that. Awesome page. Look at that. So the thing is that he goes there because he needs 5 people to make a team to help him go to Santa Prisca. So he goes, the first person that he needs to help him is the Ventriloquist. You might be wondering why he needs the Ventriloquist. I was wondering that myself. Helicopter. Okay, sorry about that. Anyway, I was wondering myself why Batman needs the Ventriloquist. Although eventually we're going to find out again. The next guy, the next person that he needs is Jeremiah. That's the one that he needs, which happens to be Rome's tiger. I think no, it's not Rome's tiger. Yes, it's Rome's tiger. Well, just Rome's tiger to say hello to government is, well,
yes,
they start fighting. Which eventually, Rome's tiger says, okay, fine, I'm gonna help you, and this and that. So the next person that he goes after is June, as we can see here, and her boyfriend, Punchy. Which Punchy happens to be the guy that is dressed up as James Gordon. He was smart. So they also, he talked to all of them, and then the last one that he needs, which seems like it's the worst of the worst. And our time, he's not too happy. He's going like, no, not that. Pick anyone, pick anybody. But that, I mean, that's the worst of the worst. And, you know, I mean, come on. I mean, don't. Pick anybody. Not that. Well, the thing is that Batman says, I want that. I need that. So, as you can see here, that person is all tied up, has a mask, just like the Silence of the man. Okay. And the end happens to be, well, who else? Catwoman. Because she happens to kill about 200 people, 500 people. Adam. 237 counts of murder. So she has life with no parole. And maybe she will be death penalty. That's a lot of people are cheating. Well, that's just part one. Part one is more like a setup of what's coming next. So issue number two, part two is more like, well, he has a team, so now he decides to go to Santa Fe on his Batman, as we can see. As soon as he got close to the island, well, Santa Prisca has his own army, air force, and his angels. His bad plane just got blown out of the sky, but he managed to land. So, when he's getting closer to the prison, so he stopped fighting. Like, well, I mean, what does this mean? So he stopped fighting, but the difference about this fighting, excuse me, and the rest of the other fighters is he actually fights a whole army. Starts here and then moves up here, over here, and then on the last panel, look at it. They look like ants. Look how many people Batman's fighting. All by himself. I mean, I know that Batman is a good fighter, but God. You couldn't fight him against, what, 100 people here? Just by looking at it, I would say there are about 250 people here. And finally, he got his ass beat up, which I believe, well, which he didn't purpose all because he wants to be inside the prison. So he was taken to Bane. And Bane started beating him up and talking trash. He said, well, I don't need the Venom anymore. I'm free of that drug, so I delete that, and you're lucky that night you see I don't have Venom in my system, otherwise I would break you back again, but now that I'm free of Venom, I can do it. Actually, I'm gonna do it worse. So that's the attitude that Bane has. Not only that, all through his whole issue, Bane is naked. But naked, I know. So Bane's kind of like, crack Batman's back, check that out. And he threw him to the same cell that he had when, at the beginning of part one, when he was a kid. Right here. Yeah. So here is Batman. Same position when Bane was when he was a kid. Check that out. So, finally, Batman recovers, so he starts punching the walls. Since it's the wall made out of concrete, but weak concrete. So he kind of like climbed the wall and to put his back So what he did, he dragged his dad himself to get his dad back together. If that makes any sense. But actually, he just dragged his dad again. Himself, that is. That is. So that way he can fix his dad by tracking his dad. Whatever. So he managed to escape all the cell. And he see Catwoman on the beach with the clitoris. That's okay. I mean, this story, like I said before, is really simple, straightforward. Kind of like it just reminds me of one of those movies. One of those rescues mission movies. It reminds me of that. So issue part 3, issue number 11. So I love this cover. Awesome cover. It will look nice here on the wall. I think it will look nice over here. What do you think? Yeah. Maybe. So the thing is that we get a little bit of backstory between Batman and Catwoman on the rooftop. So the thing is that they managed to get inside. Catwoman and Pinkfield. Now, on the other side of the island, in the meeting, first we see Punchy and Jewel, dressed as clown and bronze tiger. That's the other part of the plan of Batman. We can see here. You see, the reason that Batman took Punchy, which I can explain you after I show you this spreadsheet, which because I love it. Look at this. Look at this. Just awesome. I like the way just two is just one panel. You just follow the balloons from left to right, but going left all the way down, then go up a bit, and then down. Just I love it. Really nice spread page. So, Bronze Tiger is talking to Bane. Say, look, I got this guy here. The thing about punching, or punch, is that he's the only one who actually escapes Santa Prisca, not Bane. He was the only one who escaped. Although, if you're wondering how Bane escaped, well, actually he made himself kind of like he managed to control his heartbeat to the point where kind of like he's dead, so he was thrown over the cliff to the shark. That's how Bane escaped. And you can read it on Vengeance of Bane, one shot. That's from 1998, I believe so. That's how Bane escaped. But Punchy, he's the only one who actually escaped. And that, I don't know how he escaped, whether it was the same way as Bane or not, I don't know. So anyway, so the thing is that he has an interview with Bane. And not only that, Catwoman betrayed all of them. Catwoman told Bane, look, this is a setup. Bronze Tiger, he's just keeping your mind busy, while Batman behind you is going to use because he wants to bring you back. Now, these two guys are just idiots. They're just using him as bait. Oh, the only guy who can escape Santa Prisca, big deal. So, Bane gets furious, he gets pissed off. He says, what? You're trying to play me? No way. So the thing is that, well, Bane punch everybody. And Batman goes punching too. This time he's punching more soldiers. Look at that. I thought at the beginning of the story, Batman, he just knocked out at least all his army. Because remember the first issue that we saw about 200 or 300 soldiers fighting just one guy? That was Batman. And Batman, he's not metahuman. I'm wondering what kind of damage Batman would do if he had superpowers. Oh boy, he would be unstoppable. He would be unstoppable. Oh yeah, he would be worse than Superman. He would be kind of like Doom. Kind of. Okay, back to the story. So we see, you know, Batman running, punching, kicking his way through. screw another, the other half of the army. As well. So I like this is another great page because you get to see, it's kind of like, okay, they show you the old castle. I mean, I don't know if you can see it, but you can see where Batman is going. All the way to the top over here. Different drawings, different position of the Batman. I like that. Kind of like going with the light, it goes in numbers. I like that. So he managed to jump, this and that. So he goes inside another place of the Santa Prisca and he's getting shot at again. The thing is that but again, I mean, I don't know. I mean, I know that Batman is Batman, but I'll be honest with you, they went a little bit overboard on this story. Way too overboard to the sense that that is not, they just went overboard. I mean, I know that Batman is Batman, he can do a lot of stuff, but to fight a full army, 200 people, and top of that, again, in close quarters, look at that. I mean, he's lucky that he didn't get shot because, well, since everybody just cramped one another, so I guess they didn't dare to shoot at him to avoid shooting one of their own. That's the only reason I can think of. But still, look at that. I mean, they went overboard. They went a bit too old. And look at it. And that's an army. So, other than that, we see that Batman is kind of taking his breath and get his war. Okay. Awesome one. I like these two pages. You can see the sequence. I like it. I like it when artists use sequence. On the work, I like that. So we see that finally Batman shows where Bane is at. And the thing is that right there is when part 13, actually issue number 13. So here's when the final confrontation between Batman and Bane. Not only that, we see Amanda Waller inside the Batcave. Imagine that. So right here, Alfred tells her, look, Batman's not here. I know he's not here because he's fighting the Suicide Squad and all that stuff. Which says here in a small caption, you should read Justice League versus Suicide Squad. Anyway, so the thing is that Batman and Bane are fighting. Actually, Batman getting his ass kicked by Bane while everybody's waiting for his order, to give the order. When finally he gets his ass kicked, check that out. Look at that. Once he got his ass kicked, is when he gives the order. Check that out. Awesome, huh? Look at that. You're awesome. It gives the order. So what it does is that Catwoman used her whip around Bane's neck. Punchy and her girlfriend are chewing bubblegum and they create two giant bubblegum balls, I think it's called. I think, yeah. Right here. And that eventually will make, which I'm going to show you later on, I was wondering about it, why those two, that couple is chewing gum? I mean, they are not supposed to be fighting? Well, that's the thing, man. You see, the reason is that Ron's Tiger chewed, or at least Ron's Tiger, Batman chewed, punching to Bane is because he was the only one. So that was kind of like his present from Bronze Tiger to him. Because the idea of bronze tiger taking punchy to Ben was, okay, look, I got this guy, punchy, he's the only one who actually escaped. And you're the only one who actually got close to Batman. But I've been hired by the League of Assassins to kill Batman. And since you're the only one who actually got close to Batman, actually to break his back, well, I will actually have some points from you. Which Bane, he did not love. He did not like that, because at that moment when Bane was going to tell him, that's when Catwoman betrayed, supposed to betray everyone, which everything was part of Batman plan. So here we see the Bronze Tiger escape and bump to the Ventriloquist. Why the Ventriloquist there? I don't know. Which I was wondering on top of that. So the thing is that they finally knocked out Bane. And they apprehend Psycho Pirate. The thing is that Batman tells the Ventriloquist, look, go after, take over Psycho Pirate. And the Ventriloquist does that. The thing is that Psycho Pirate, he has the ability to control everybody's mind. But something happens that the Ventriloquist, he cannot be controlled, because the only person who can control the Ventriloquist is Scarface, his puppet. That's why, on the end of the story, that everything makes sense. Why he took the Ventriloquist? And it's because of it. Because Scarface always says, nobody can control the Ventriloquist but Scarface, his puppet. So even though that the Psycho Pirate, he, no matter how many times he would try to control the Ventriloquist, it would never work, because the only person who can control the Ventriloquist is Scott. This believe it or not. Ah, that was awesome. I like that kind of twist. And also, the thing is that one of the reasons why Bane quit using Venom and he doesn't have that urge or anything is because of Psycho Pirate. So even though that Bane, he was addicted to it, and he was getting, by not using it, he was getting his shakes or whatever, well, Psycho Pirate, he can control people's mind. When he was controlling Bane's mind, in a sense, taking the urge or the pain by not having the Venom. That was awesome, and I was not expecting that. So, finally, we see that, remember that couple that they were chewing gum? Well, they managed to do a light bulb. Believe it or not, I would like to know what kind of chewing gum is that. What kind of bubble gum is that? So the thing is that Batman tells Bane, say, look, you can always stop and you can always change. But we know that that's not going to happen. The thing is that, you see, Batman, he makes a deal with each member of his team. The couple, Catwoman, Bronze Tiger, and the Ventriloquist. The thing is that, once that Bane wakes up, he starts screaming, give me Venom, I need Venom. And that was the end of the story. Look at that, even with music and all. I forgot to put my phone in mute. Sorry about that. So, it was a good story. I really liked it. It was a fun story. It was fun. It was very, I would say that, I mean, there was a story written before the New 52 book, and I have not read it, but this was good. And we know that the story will continue, that when Bane is going to Gotham City, and this and that, so, but it was good. I really like it, that I will give it 4.5 out of 5. Now that you need to read the first story arc, well, I would say that yes, but I mean, if you are not reading Batman and you want to jump in, well, jump in on the first volume of Batman, the first story arc, I am Gautam. I am Gautam. And then follow Bhishma. Because they are, I mean, both stories are connected. And now we give it 4.5 out of 5. It was a fun week. It was a fun popcorn reading. It's kind of like watching a movie with a large soda and popcorn. That's it. It was fun. What can I say? I like it. And I'm going to choose the best cover. Which is the best cover? It's going to be this one. So I love it. Look at that. Awesome cover. Well, guys, this is it. I hope that you like this video. See you later.